A lot of woodworkers remain reluctant to use CAD software due to they didn't used to be intuitive or easy to use. I can say that once you take a few minutes to learn the basic functions, you will end using them for all your projects. The drawing, understanding and measurement of the plans will be much quicker and easier. Today I'm gonna talk to you about SketchUp, one of the most popular 3D CAD software. It is very easy to use and the free version has almost all an amateur woodworking can need. We can download it in SketchUp.com. Click on Download SketchUp and select Personal Projects. This way you will get the free version of SketchUp, SketchUp Make, and you'll be able to try the pro version for a month. Select your professional interest, your operation system, and read the license and click on Download. Click to install it. Next, select the folder if you want, install, and finish. You read the end user license agreements, continue, and that's it. Choose the template you want to work with. I'm gonna go with woodworking and millimeters and start using SketchUp. In the Make edition, there are only a few things you cannot do, as import or export CAD files, export to PDF, print to scale, etc. You can view the complete list online here. Almost all the tools in SketchUp are very intuitive, so I'm gonna tell you a few important tips that can be useful if you're a beginner. Imagine I want to make a cube of 500 millimeters. First, I have to draw a square with the rectangle tool. Click on the point you want to start, drag it keeping an eye on the dimensions box at the lower right corner, and click again to set the final point. It can be complicated sometimes to find the exact point, but we can insert the dimensions manually. So I'll type 500 semicolon 500 again and press enter. To give it the height we need, select the push-pull tool and again type 500. As you can see in the entity info window, all the parts of my cube are in the layer 0. Anything you draw, do it in this layer and you'll have no problems. Then you create a roof or component and place it in the layer you want. To convert the cube in a component or a roof, you have to select it. Take care with the way you select. If you click and drag from right to left, the selection will include all the elements that are only partially inside the box. From left to right, it will include only elements completely within the box. If you want to include everything, you can do it using Ctrl A. Once it is selected, right-click and Make Component. Now I can make a new layer and place it there. Take special attention if you are going to duplicate these components, because they will keep the same properties of the original. So if you modify one, you'll modify them all. This can be so useful sometimes to save time. If you don't want this to happen, you can make a roof instead, or make the component unique. We can make as much layers as we need. Make them visible or hide them. And we can also activate the color by layer option, so you can easily know to which layer belongs any component. Another interesting feature is the dimension tool. If you don't see it with the other icons, you can find it in the tools menu or activating the construction toolbar. With this tool you can easily draw dimension lines between any two points in your model and move them to a layer as any other element. You may also want to activate the styles and views toolbars. They really come in handy to quickly change the camera, activate the X-ray and show or hide colors, solid faces and textures. We can also create scenes of our model where we can change the view and select the elements we want to show. You can modify the settings of the scenes going to Window Model Info Animation. In the menu camera, we can change from perspective to parallel projection. And finally, something a lot of you had asked. You can change the units anytime you want in Window Model Info Units.